Good morning to all.
Good morning, sir.
Yeah, good morning. So we will start today with whatever we have been discussing before. So we are in module 4 and we have started with the point sources. So we have also understood that what are the point sources and all those things. So Jasmeet, I'll take you through that, whatever we have discussed in the previous class, and then we'll continue further. We have started with module 4, point sources and arrays. This is what the introduction, the main thing is what you have a point source. It can be radiated in all the 360 degree angle, and you can generate the efficiency of 100% at the transmitter and receiver end. So it is not having a specified shape. And this is also called as the isotropic antenna. So this is what we discussed in the previous class. Now further on, we have started with the pattern. So already you know that patterns are the just graphical representation of the radiation. And we also know that patterns are classified into two, that is power pattern and field pattern. Here we are going to see the power pattern way of an isotropic antenna. So you can see that the antenna can, it is in the two, it will be represented in the form of a circle, and when it comes to three dimension, you can see that it will be in the form of a sphere. So so those things we have discussed for the power pattern, and we know that the relationship of power pattern and field pattern as well. So P is equal to E square. So that is what the relation square of field you have to take for the power. So those problems also we have done quite a lot of things. So SR divided by SRM is called as a relative power pattern, and SR is expressed in watts per square meters, and the graph is an absolute power pattern. You call it as an absolute power pattern when you divide relative power pattern. Pattern also you'll get when you divide it by its maximum value. So that is what you can see. But if SR is expressed in terms of its value in some reference direction, the graph is relative power pattern. So that is what you can see here. SR expressed in terms of its value in some reference direction, it is called as the relative power pattern. You have completed till this figure in the previous class. You can just complete those things, and we will proceed further. Already we have discussed about pattern in the previous module as well. So it's you have to make a note of all those things what you have discussed in the previous module. It's like it's not compulsory that this has to be asked in the third module. So it can be also asked in the fourth module. So if any question comes in third or fourth, doesn't matter. So you have to whatever you have studied in module 3 also you have to add to this here with respect to this pattern. So you may have to go with the 3D plot and then explain all these things, and all these points also you can add to that. So you have, what I want to say is even expressions also, whatever you studied in module 3, that can be added here. That is relative field pattern, relative power pattern. So here it is exclusively asked for power pattern. So you can normalize power pattern. What is the equation for normalized power pattern? All those things can be added here. Okay. So we have discussed in module number 3. So I will just take you there and what we have seen, and then it will be clear for you. So these are some of the equations we have studied, and when you take with the pattern, we have studied these equations, that is P and theta phi normalized equal to S theta phi divided by S theta phi maximum. So all these points need to be remembered when you are, and all these things has to be included along with what we are studying in module 4. So all of you completed this figure and this definition for absolute power pattern and relative power pattern. All of you have completed. this, in fact, till this figure we have done in the previous class. Let us move on further. We'll discuss the power theorem and all those things. Is that completed?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, continuation of that, one more point you can add there. That is the power pattern radius. So, you can see in the figure already, we have seen that it is SR divided by SRM. That is the pattern radius. So, that you can add there one more point. The pattern radius for relative power is SR divided by SRM. And what is SRM? It's the maximum value. So SRM, where SRM is the maximum value. And what is SR? SR is the relative value. So you can just take the ratio to get the power pattern radius. And the maximum value of the relative power pattern is unity. So that also we have studied in module 1. That this value, that is the maximum value at this point, will be unity 1. Okay, so those things also you can add. So you can add those things. So these points you can add there. The maximum value is unity. And the pattern with the maximum unity is also called as the normalized pattern. So these things we have seen. Now we will discuss upon the important concept, which is a well repeated question in most of the examinations. That is the power pattern and its application. So you can mark it as very important, power pattern and its application. So we are studying the power pattern and its application. You can complete this. You note down these things. After that, we'll discuss the power pattern and its application. Today, we'll do one or two problems as well, some few problems. So those things already, I have given you the assignment. So you can work on those problems. I'll be solving it here as well. So shall we start with the power theorem? So all of you have completed till power theorem.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So we will start to explain power theorem. So power theorem is actually to measure the power ratings and all those things we have to understand. So we have some specific equations in order to calculate the power, and we'll be seeing that those things here. So power theorem, we can say that we can define this power theorem with the equation. That equation is being defined in words here. So this is a very important concept, that is power theorem and its application. You can see in university question papers and all, many places it is repeated. many times, and it comes for 6 marks, 7 marks, or sometimes 8, 10 marks. So you have to understand those things. It's very simple. Just few equations are there for you to understand. So power theorem and its application. The pointing vector is known at all points of the sphere, on the sphere of radius r, from the point source in a lossless medium, and the total power radiated by the source is, this is what we have to see, is the integral over the surface of the sphere. So of radial component SR. So that is very important. Of the average pointing vector is the definition for that. So let me just once again take you through that. When you see the equation, it will be clear for you. Let me show you the equation. This is P is equal to closed integral of S dot ds, and you can write it as integral of SR dot ds. So let us read this definition once again, understand the definition once again. So what is power theorem is, the pointing vector is all is known at all points of the sphere of radius r. So from the point source in a lossless medium, so here onwards the definition starts, the total power radiated by the source is the integral over, so you can see integral over, closed integral of, integral over the surface of the sphere, so that is S, of radial component SR. So when you write closed integral of SR, of the average pointing vector, so that is what the definition says. The same equation has been put in words, so it is P is equal to closed integral of SR dot ds. So so what you can say, the power radiated by the source is the integral over the surface of the sphere of radial component SR of the average pointing vector. So it is given with the equation, power is equal to SR, integral of SR dot ds. So what is P? So this equation, you put it in a box, in closed integral of SR dot ds. So what is P? P is the power, radiated power. What is SR? SR you have already studied before as well in the previous module. That is the radial component of average pointing vector. So all of you write down the heading, power theorem and its application. Here very easy to remember these things. Should not lose marks for this power theorem. You have to write P is equal to closed integral of SRDS. Very easy to understand, very easy to score marks even. There is nothing much here. Simple equations to solve with. We are going to substitute SR here and then going to simplify the equation for P in a little more elaborate way. But the definition is very easy to understand. That is, the total power radiated by the source is the integral over the surface of the sphere of the radial component SR of the average pointing vector. So it is P is equal to closed integral of SR ds. What is P? P is the radiated power and SR is the radial component of average pointing vector. So all of you note down these points. It's very important. Power theorem and its application for an isotropic source. So this power theorem is very important as exam point of view as well. So P is equal to closed integral of S dot ds, SR dot ds. So you will be Having some problems and all, if in further to find out the directivity, power, and all those things. So P is called as the radiated power, SR is called as the radial component of average pointing vector. All the units, you know, watts and all those things. And one more component is there, ds. So ds is different and d omega is different. Here ds is infinitesimal element of area of the sphere. So that is called as the ds. And so we are going to take the integral of sr dot ds. So here what is d omega? We have seen d omega, that is beam area and all, different. This ds is entirely different, so you don't confuse with all those things. So ds is r square sine theta d theta d phi. So we have also studied this before. So ds can be defined as r square sine theta d theta d phi. So all of you note down this important equations, what P is equal to closed integral of S dot ds or SR dot ds. We can have power and SR. P is called as radiated power. SR is called as the radial component of average power pointing vector, average pointing vector. S ds is here ds, which is important, is you should know that it is r square sine theta d theta d phi. If you are, you will not be using ds as such, you will be using r square sine theta d theta d phi if you are solving problems and all. So you need to know that ds can be represented as r square sine theta d theta d phi. So complete all these equations. So all of you make a note of all these things in your book so that you can revise it once again. So is that completed? We will move on further.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So we understood the equation for power, radiated power. We also seen the definition for radiated power as the source. It means total radiated power by the source is the integral over the surface of the sphere of radial component SR of the average pointing vector. So it is defined as SR dot ds, closed integral of P is power radiated, SR is radial component, and ds is r square sine theta d theta d phi. So let us go further. Yeah, for an isotropic source, SR is independent of isotropic source, means that is the point source. So for so you don't have a definite shape for that, you don't have you radiate the signal in all the directions and efficiency is also 100%. So for that source, an isotropic point source, SR is independent of theta and phi. So what you have to go with, we have defined power as closed integral of SR dot ds. So I am taking it outside SR, I am taking it outside since it is independent of theta and phi. Integral of ds it will come. So what is ds? Ds is r square sine theta d theta d phi. So when you go for this r square sine theta d theta d phi, you have studied all these things before. You have to go back and check all these things we have studied here. See, we have seen here r square sine theta d theta d phi, r square sine theta you will get. So when you can see here, you can see here dA is r square sine theta d theta d phi, and d omega was sine theta d theta d phi. So what is here? We are taking it as ds. So ds is same as that of what we have seen before. So ds is r square sine theta d theta d phi. When you are taking sr is independent of theta and phi, So when you do that integral of ds, you will get it as 4 pi r square. So the final power equation will be P is equal to sr into 4 pi r square, or from this equation P is equal to sr into 4 pi r square, you can write sr. Sr can be written as P divided by 4 pi r square, just rearranging the equation here and there to get the specified equation. That is what we got. P is equal to sr into 4 pi r square, or sr can be written as P divided by 4 pi r square. So what is sr? Sr is the radial component of the average pointing vector. So if you want to find out that, if you know the power, you can go with P divided by 4 pi r square. So this few points you can make a note of it. Here the magnitude of the pointing vector varies inverse to the square of the distance from the point source radiator. So that is what it is. So here all we are going to discuss about the equations, two to three equations you need to remember. P is equal to integral of closed integral of sr dot ds, and when you are writing the equation for sr, you can write it as P divided by 4 pi r square. That's all about this power theorem. You can just make a note of all of these equations, and then we will move on to radiation intensity. So one thing I want to give you as an assignment here itself, I have already given an assignment for you. So power theorem, and you need to write application. So what you have to do is go through the internet and write down power theorem and its application. Just pick one or two applications and you write it there. Okay, when you are writing the answer for your assignment, if you have already written, just add to the same place two applications, one or two applications. So if it is asked for your examination also, you need to add those things. Just very brief, you can add two applications there. Okay, so mainly this power theorem will be used in order to calculate the flow of power, and what is the power received at the receiver and all those things. So you can see that it can be used in many applications, like there are military applications, but you can go a little more specific and check, go through the net for 2 minutes, you will get that answer to that, and just add to that assignment. Okay, what is given for you, you can make a note of that in your notebook as well. So that you have to do, just takes 2 minutes, you can complete it. So let us go ahead with the power theorem is done with. Now we can go with radiation intensity. So all of you have completed power theorem. Is that clear for all of you?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so we will go ahead with the radiation intensity, that is U. This is radiation intensity is represented as U, and the unit is watts per unit solid angle. Its equation for radiation intensity to calculate, it is U is equal to P divided by 4 pi or R square SR. What is SR? SR, just now we have written SR is P divided by 4 pi R square. R square, R square get cancelled. So U will be P divided by 4 pi. So the power theorem can be restricted as the total power radiated is given by integral of the radiation intensity as well. You can call this also, you can add when you are writing for the answer. Power theorem can be restricted as the total power radiated is given by the integral of the radiation intensity also. You can say in that way, because you can get U is equal to P divided by 4 pi. So it can also be written in that way. We'll see that further. You complete this equation, U is equal to R square SR, substitute SR from the above equation, it is available. So it is P divided by 4 pi. So we can rewrite the definition for power radiated or power theorem in terms of for radiation intensity as well, that is U. So if power theorem is asked, you should not stop it till this point. You need to just specify these things as well. This power theorem can be restricted as the total power radiated is given by the integral of radiation intensity. This point also you need to add to that, okay? So now we have done with the theory part of it. We'll be solving one or two problems based on finding the directivity. So I have been saying you that integration and trigonometric relationships, make a note of all those things. So it will be required for you to simplify a few notations and complete the calculation for directivity and all those things. We'll see that. So have you completed till here? So all these things you need to study for your internals, whatever I complete till today. From the beginning of second IA, half portion of the second IA. Sorry, second module half, from second module half, third module complete, and this fourth module till where I complete today, all these problems and all those things. So have you completed?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So we have seen the equation U is equal to P divided by 4 pi, and we will further simplify that little more. So you can see here, we can simplify that still more. That is what we were saying, the definition for that before. The power theorem can be restricted as the total power radiated is given by the integral of radiation intensity. So we have to take it over a solid angle of 4 pi steradians. So that is what we will see. W, this is a few new equations, not new, you have seen this in module 3 as well. So WT is what you are going to say, in phi is equal to 0 to 2 pi 0 to theta 0 to pi U of d omega. D omega is a non-term for you, that is sine theta d pi. So I am going to substitute d omega here. So WT can be written as integral of 0 to 2 pi 0 to pi U sine theta d pi. So this is very important equation for WT. And directivity in terms of WT can be written as 4 pi UM divided by WT. So we are going to see that how the power can be calculated. Power means WT is integral of 0 to 2 pi 0 to pi U sine theta d phi, and also we will see that how the directivity can be calculated. So the first third module of antennas, you have some problems, different types of problems to calculate directivity and all. In this module you have to find out the directivity of the intensity pattern by using the examples of power pattern and all those things. So slightly here you can see that it is defined in terms of 4 pi UM divided by WT. This equation remains the WT is integral of 0 to 2 pi 0 to pi U sin theta d phi. So it's not much of the changes there. So but you need to understand that how this has to be done for the power pattern. All of you have noted down the equation. This is very important equation for WT, integral of 0 to 2 pi, 0 to pi u sin theta d theta d phi, or you can write it as u d omega, and the directivity is 4 pi um by WT. So if you are asked to find out the directivity, first you need to find out WT, and you need to substitute u and all which is given in the question, and then you have to put it here in the equation for directivity and find out directivity. So we'll now solve a few problems for you to understand these things. So some examples some problems you can write, understand these things carefully. Examples of power patterns. If you understand one, it is enough. You can solve all the six. Okay. So you understand the first one properly. Some key points I'm going to say here, which you should remember. So let us, if you have written the equation for directivity 4 pi um by WT completed.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so just listen to this first problem. Means I am not going to solve the entire problem. Integration, till integration I will make you to understand. After that, so it's just integration. But what are the key points you should remember? And any problem comes like this, what you should keep it in your mind. That is what we will be discussing now. So here they are asking you to find the direction of the intensity pattern. So this is very important. They are asking you to find out these are examples of power patterns, all those what we are solving here. So first thing what they are asking you is find the directivity of the intensity pattern. So here some key important points which every student should know is, see here, unidirectional cosine pattern. If it is asked for you unidirectional cosine pattern or unidirectional sine pattern or unidirectional cosine square pattern or unidirectional sine square pattern, anything it is there. So unidirectional cosine pattern, if it is told, unidirection means you have to define the limits in this form. That is, no need to say the when it is told unidirection, no need to specify the limits. So unidirection means you have to specify the limits in this form. Unidirection means it will be 0 to 0 less than or equal to theta less than or equal to pi by 2. Nobody will say this again. If it is unidirection, it is 0 to pi by 2. If it is unidirection, phi will range from 0 to 2 pi. So 0 less than or equal to theta less than or equal to pi by 2, 0 less than or equal to phi less than or equal to 2 pi. Limits, no need to, if it is enough to ask, explain or solve the unidirectional cosine pattern or solve the bidirectional cosine pattern or, so that also I will tell you what it is. Two terms are there, one is unidirection, another is called as bidirection. So bidirectional means what? A small change here, that is, here it is 0 to pi. Theta will range from 0 to pi and phi will range from 0 to 2 pi. So this is the change between unidirection and bidirection. Unidirection, it is 0 to pi by 2, but 0 less than or equal to theta less than or equal to pi by 2. But in bidirection, you have to take the limit 0 less than or equal to theta less than or equal to pi. The other one is still pi by 2. Here in bidirection, it is still pi. Now let us see another thing here. Cosine pattern. Cosine pattern means this equation you should be able to write it. U is equal to um cos theta. Here you can see here the other one. I will just compare. Here also it is bidirectional cosine pattern. So you have used u is equal to um cos theta. I will take another example here. Unidirectional sine pattern, okay, let us go further. Unidirectional sine pattern, bidirectional sine pattern. Yeah, bidirectional sine squared pattern. So what you have to write, u is equal to u m sine square theta you need to write. So that is what you have to understand. Bidirectional means you need to take the limits from 0 to pi and 0 to 2 pi. So those things, all those things, if you understand, you can solve all these problems properly. Just all the things are just a substitution in the equation and simplification with the help of integration. So is that clear for everyone? So few points, what it is, cos means cos pattern means you have to write u is equal to um sine theta, and you have to take the limits from 0 to pi by 2, 0 to 2 pi for unidirection. Bidirection means u is equal to um sine theta, and the limits you have to take from 0 to pi. Bidirection means you can see in bidirection you have to take from 0 to pi. Unidirection you have to take from 0 to pi by 2. So is that clear for all of you? Is that clear for all of you? Here very few things I will just tell you few things. Unidirectional cosine pattern means you should write u is equal to um cos theta, and the limit should be 0 to pi by 2 for theta. And if it is bidirectional cosine pattern means you have to write u is equal to um cos theta, and the limits will be from 0 to pi. Bidirection means 0 to pi. Unidirection means 0 to pi by 2. That much is enough to remember. Is that clear for everyone?
Yes, sir.
Then let us substitute this using the equation here. Whatever we have studied now, UWT and directivity, these equations we are going to use in order to simplify this problem. So let us write down this problem first. Write down this problem. Unidirectional cos pattern. U is equal to um cos theta. 0 less than unidirection. That's why limits will be 0 less than or equal to theta less than or equal to pi by 2. And phi will be 0 to 2 pi. So the total power radiated, we have the equation for that. So what we are asked to find out is directivity. So what it is directivity? Directivity is 4 pi um by WT. What is required first? WT. First you should find out WT. Then you need to substitute in the equation for directivity and find out directivity. So first our work is to find out WT. So let us all find WT. What is given for you? WT equation, you know that integral of 0 to 2 pi, 0 to pi by 2, because it is unidirectional, limits are 0 to pi by 2 for theta. So that is um u d omega. So d omega is sine theta d phi. What is u? U is, since it is unidirectional cos pattern, so we can write u is equal to u cos theta. So I have substituted u here. Then just I have taken the um term outside, and rest of the things are depending on theta. So we need to integrate it. So integral of 0 to 2 pi d phi, because phi ranges from 0 to 2 pi and theta ranges from 0 to pi by 2. So you need to integrate it. So all of you are good with trigonometric and integration. So you can find out the answer for that. You need to integrate 0 to 2, 0 to pi by 2 cos theta sine theta d theta. Integrate this term, 0 to pi by 2 cos theta d theta, cos theta sine theta d theta, and integrate for d phi for the limit 0 to 2 pi. This is for the limit 0 to pi by 2. This one problem you understand means rest of the problems you can solve it. There is no problem. So how to integrate for integral? So let me take this separate, 0 to pi by 2 cos theta sine theta d theta separately, and I will complete that, then substitute here. So let me take that term separate and integrate it. So the method of doing integration is substitute cos theta is equal to t. So when you do substitute cos theta is equal to t, you will get minus sine theta d theta equal to dt. Find the limits for theta is equal to 0. You are all good in integration. Just do it. So all these things you can complete it. So when you substitute cos theta is equal to t, you will get minus sine theta d theta is equal to dt. And theta is equal to 0, t will be equal to 1, and theta pi by 2, t will be equal to 0. So let me define the limits for that. So my limits will be 1 to 0 minus t dt. So it's very easy to integrate 1 to 0 minus t dt. Integrate for minus t dt for the limits 1 to 0. And also integrate for 0 to 2 pi d phi. So when you integrate for 0 to 2 pi d phi, you will get 2 pi. And you need to integrate for 1 to 0 minus t dt. You can also write it as, since negative sign is there, there is a property in integration. You all know that you can shuffle the limits. You can shuffle the limits. So you can see that I have removed the negative sign and I have shuffled the limits. That is, it was 1 to 0. Now I made it as 0 to 1. I removed that negative sign there. So integral of 0 to 1 t dt can be written as, what is integration of t? All these things, I think you know that. If you don't know, you should know these things. This is all you have been doing from 10th standard or 12th onwards, 11th onwards. So almost you have done from almost 3 to 4 years, you have done integration. So integration of 0 to 1 t dt can be written as t square divided by 2 for the limit 0 to 1. So now it is very easy to solve it. So it is, you have to substitute the limits, upper limit minus lower limit. All of you have noted down this problem, no? All of you have started solving this problem?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So till where you reached? Till what is the value you have got for WT?
UM pi, sir.
Let me check that. Pi UM, correct. So you will get pi UM. So after that, what is next? You are asked to find out the directivity. So what is the equation for directivity? We have seen directivity is equal to 4 pi UM by WT. So substitute WT for that equation. So you'll get D is equal to 4 pi UM by WT. WT is pi UM. Substitute here, you'll get the answer 4. Once you complete it, you start doing this one, bidirectional cosine pattern. So for bidirectional cosine pattern, what you have to do? For bidirectional cosine pattern, you have to take u is equal to um cos theta. Limit will change from 0 to pi. It is not 0 to pi by 2. For unidirection, it is 0 to pi by 2. For bidirection, it is 0 to 0 less than or equal to theta less than or equal to pi, and 0 less than or equal to pi less than or equal to 2 pi. So you need to solve it. Same method, first WT, substitute WT in directivity, find the directivity. So you can start doing that bidirectional cosine pattern. So I have substituted here u is equal to um cos theta for the limit 0 to pi and 0 to 2 pi. So let me substitute u is equal to u cos theta for that limits. Since the variation of limits are there, you have to do the integration. So it will be slightly changing here. So um cos theta sin theta d theta d pi. Now you will get it as integral of 0 to 2 pi, 0 to pi um cos theta sin theta d theta d pi. So you have just substituted it. Integral of 0 to 2 pi d pi, integral of 0 to pi cos theta d theta, cos theta sin theta d theta, 0 to pi. It is not pi by 2, okay? Here in bidirectional it is 0 to pi. So try solving the integration for d phi as usual we have done. You know that it is 2 pi and cos theta sin theta d phi, d theta you can integrate for 0 to pi. So anyone could complete it? What is WT for bidirectional cosine pattern? If you are very fast in integration, it takes 2 minutes to complete. So all of you have completed till here, no? So you may finally see, you can see that you have to use this method in order to do that. So you have to do in this way. So you might have forgotten it. You have 0 to pi cos theta sin theta d theta can be written as 2 times of, you can make the limits half of that. So 0 to pi by 2 cos theta sin theta d theta. You might have forgotten it. It's a property of integration. That 0 to, because if you solve it, it may be coming towards 0 for the limit 0 to pi. So that is not acceptable. So what you have to do is you have to take 2 times so by 2 cos theta sin theta d theta. So we have already done 0 to pi by 2 cos theta sin theta d theta is 1 by 2. So it you will get it as 2 pi um. And directivity, when you substitute it, you'll get 2. Once you complete that, you can go ahead with the unidirectional sine pattern. And you will get u is equal to um sine theta for the limits, this one. So any problem can be given here. Unidirectional sine, cos, bidirectional sine. All these things I have even sent you these notes. You can refer to that. And you can solve all this integration part. All of you got the directivity as 2?
Yes, sir.
Okay, then do for the next one, that is unidirectional sine pattern. So unidirection means 0 to pi by 2. That is very important for you to remember. Rest all the things, instead of sine, you put it as cos. And keep in place of cos, you put it as sine and keep going. And you have to do the integration. You can complete the integration for that. You will end up with the answer pi. So you have to do WT is equal to um sine square theta d phi. So when you complete it, you'll get pi square um by 2. Directivity, you'll get it as 2.54. Now find out that. So we will stop it for today here, and you can also find along with this rest of the things as well, that is bidirectional sine pattern and bidirectional sine squared pattern also. You can try those things. You can write that u is equal to bidirectional u is equal to um sine theta 0 to 2 pi 0 to pi, and sine square pattern will be 0 to u is equal to um sine square theta. So all those things you can do the integration, find out the directivity. All these things are given for you in the notes. You can compare whether you are getting the answer properly, whether you are doing the integrations properly. There is nothing beyond that integration. Everything equations are we have already discussed. You can just go through all these things and complete all these problems. Okay. So you do for bidirectional sine square, bidirectional cos square, all those things you complete it. Okay, with that, I will stop it for today. Thank you. So all of you can study well for yourselves. Thank you. Thank you.